Hi, and welcome to my channel. I recently published a video where I tackled the challenge of managing harsh light. While in that previous demonstration, I had full control over the scene because I was the subject, but in real world situations, especially when covering sporting or other public events, you have no control over your subjects or the weather conditions. So imagine you have an up and coming event and the weather forecast predicts brilliant sunshine. This is exactly the situation I faced when I covered an Ironman event in my local town. It was a brilliantly sunny day with not a cloud in sight, and I approached this situation in a way that allowed me to take advantage of the harsh light rather than viewing it as a disadvantage. So in this video, I'll share my experience and show you how I captured the sport in action using the harsh light to my advantage. So let's dive in. First is to have a good understanding of the direction of light and how it affects your subjects. Light is the foundation of photography. The direction of the light relative to your camera will determine how the image is perceived. So then you have top-down light. And if it's in the middle of the day, you're going to create unflattering shadows across the face, like the eyes and the nose. So I tend to look for shaded areas in those conditions. And then you have front light. That means the sun's low in the sky. It's directly behind you and it's shining onto the subject. It will create a nice evenly lit subject. Then you have side light, which is 90 degrees to you and it's got 50% light on the subject and 50% shadows. Then you have back light, which means you can create a nice silhouette. So the edge of the subject will be evenly lit across with the sun and then you can just expose for the shadows, which creates a nice even light there as well. In order to plan my shoot, I need to know the safety rules of the event, which allow me then to determine the location for which I can operate in. And checking the map of the course, I can pick the different locations to capture the action of the event. And I use an app called PhotoPills to give me the information of the direction of the sunlight at these locations. So when I arrive at the area, I set the camera up and there's exposure for a certain area of that location. And then I wait for the athlete to enter that area so I can capture them in exactly the lighting conditions I want. So how I set my camera up was a fast shutter speed, 1/800 of a second, wide open aperture, f2.8, to separate the subject from the background, and then the ISOs just to make sure I got the exposure correct. And I use the histogram as a guide to ensure that I don't blow out the highlights or underexpose the shadows. As you're dealing with harsh light, you're going to get a contrasty environment, and that means you're going to get a spike in the highlights and a spike in the shadows. But as long as they're not clipping either side of the histogram, then you know you're going to retain the details in the highlights and the shadows. And then to ensure the camera's going to capture the sport in action in the area for which I've exposed for, I set the autofocus to continuous or servo mode if you've got a Canon. And then I've set my tracking mode to enable on the camera. And also I've set continuous burst, so it allows the camera, I can pick the subject up just before it enters the area for which I do want to nail the shot, and it just takes a continuous set of shots all the way through into that area. So then I can guarantee that I'm going to nail that shot. So at this location I had side light conditions, but it wasn't quite 90 degrees where you got 50% the subject lit and 50% in the shadow. It's more like 45 degrees and I preferred that, because then I had majority of the subject in the highlights and then just a smaller proportion in the shadows, which is exactly what I wanted to achieve. So it's good to then look at the conditions and then orientate yourself around relative to where the sunlight's coming from to get the type of light that you're looking for. So at the second location, that was all backlit. So I was exposing for the shadows. What I mean by that was I was pushing to the right, exposing to the right a little bit more, lifting the shadows, but using the histogram again as a guide to make sure I didn't clip the right hand side and blow out the highlights. And I caught some great action shots on the corner there as they come round. I was really pleased with that. And later on in the day at that location, as the sun moved around a little bit more, I just moved across the road and then I decided to do some panning shots as well to get some motion blur behind the cyclists and really capture that action of that, really emphasize the speed and the pace that they're riding at. I was really pleased with the results from that as well. And at the running event, I captured them alongside the river where I had side light, and it's later in the day, so the sun's a little bit lower, so the light was a bit softer, but it really punched out the colors on their clothes. I was pleased about that. Then I captured them in the shade as well, but the colours on the clothing wasn't so have so much energy, if you like. And then at the watering station, where it's so hot, I really captured the drama of the struggle that they were going through. And as the volunteers are spraying them down, the sunlight really lit up the droplets in the air, and I was happy to capture all that. So I was really pleased with the photos I got there as well. So I never worry about going out and shooting in the harsh light, because I use a polarizer to calm down the highlights. I use the histogram to manage the contrast between shadows and the highlights, so I don't clip either side. And in certain circumstances, I push to the right hand side a little bit more to lift the shadows, and use the light bounce, so where it bounces off other surfaces, I can use that reflective light and take advantage of that as well. So I never worry about shooting in a harsh light, and it frees me up then. So if an event comes up and it's bright sunny day, I know exactly what to do and what type of shots I want to capture, and when to avoid the harsh lights and when not to. But it allows me then to explore photography a little bit more and get some different style of photos that I really want. And look out for my preset pack, because I'll be releasing that soon, because all the photos you see here, applied all my presets to them, just making some final touches to make sure they can work on a varied amount of photographs. So if you did like this video, hit that subscribe button, press the like button and the notification bell, put comments down below, because I really look forward to reading them, and I'll see you in the next one.